countries race to evacuate their citizens from the conflict-torn nation. The Philippines has already rescued 50 Filipinos who are now headed to Egypt. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us with more details. Kat, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. That's right. 50 Filipinos are part of the first batch of the Philippine government's efforts to evacuate Filipino nationals from war-torn Sudan. That's according to Department of Foreign Affairs spokesperson Teresita Daza, who earlier told reporters that as of 8 p.m. Manila time yesterday, that's April 24, the first batch has already left Khartoum by land, and they are expecting to travel to the city of Aswan, where there is a functioning airport, and that they are expected to board a flight to Cairo in Egypt. Now, there are, the DSA earlier said that there are at least 696 registered Filipinos in Sudan, with around 156 of whom have travel documents and are prepared to evacuate at any given time. So far, Carmina, we have no word yet as to how many Filipinos will be included in the second batch and how many succeeding batches there will be for these evacuations or repatriation efforts. What we do know is that the DFA confirmed that the bottleneck with regard to the evacuation and repatriation of these Filipino citizens mostly stem from the lack of travel documents, particularly because some Filipino workers in Sudan, their passports are kept by either their employers or their companies. That's why they have no immediate access to these travel documents that will be needed once they cross the border between Sudan and Egypt. Fermina.
Thanks a lot, Katrina Domingo, there joining us on the line. Warring military leaders in Sudan agree to a 72-hour ceasefire as countries race to rescue their citizens from the crisis-hit country. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says the truce will begin Tuesday. He adds Washington is exploring options to return a diplomatic consular presence to the country as soon as possible.
Now, keep in mind as well that the overwhelming majority of American citizens in Sudan are dual nationals who have made their lives there, been living there for years, for decades, for generations, and many want to continue to do that. But for those who are seeking to leave, we'll continue to engage directly with them to see what we can do to help them, and as I said, with allies and partners as well help facilitate their departure.
Doubts remain on whether the Sudan Armed Forces and the paramilitary group RSF will abide by the agreement as the two sides failed to follow several previous truce deals. The fighting has left more than 420 dead and thousands hurt. In Kenya, police have recovered at least 73 bodies from mass graves in a forest are believed to be followers of a starvation cult. Police warned the death toll is still expected to rise. Authorities said followers of the Christian cult were made to believe they will go to heaven if they starve themselves. The cult's leader was arrested April 14 following a tip about the graves. Exhumations of the mass graves continue. U.S. President Joe Biden expected to finally announce his re-election bid Tuesday. There has been no official confirmation about the move, but multiple U.S. media are reporting the announcement will come through a video address. With his expected re-election bid, Biden will be defying lukewarm polls and worries about his age. The 80-year-old Biden, or at 80 rather, Biden is the oldest ever U.S. president.
He's going to be 82 should he be reelected, and he, if he serves out the entirety of a second term, he'll be closer to 90 than he will be to 80. And this raises lots of concerns, justifiable concerns in my view, about his ability to fulfill all the obligations of the office, concerns about his health, his ability to actually finish out a second term and what that means for the possibility of a President Harris stepping in. There are lots of concerns that are raised in that space.
Biden's re-election campaign sets up a potential rematch with his 2020 rival, former U.S. President Donald Trump. The 76-year-old Republican has already announced his comeback bid. Trump is a strong frontrunner to be his party's nominee despite having been criminally indicted recently.